बंध, व्हाट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द बंध, आश्रव वी आर एक्वायरिंग कर्म, नाउ व्हाट टाइप ऑफ द कर्म, दीज आर द फोर कैटेगरीज और कैटेगरीज ऑफ और क्वालिटीज ऑफ द कर्म. प्रकृति बंध, प्रकृति बंध मीन्स what is the type of the karma or nature of the karma. Now what do you mean by nature? Means you heard about there are 8 categories of karma: gnanavarniya karma, darshanavarniya karma, vedaniya, antraya, all those karmas we have it now, 4 ghati and 4 aghati karmas, all right? They all fall into prakriti bandh category. Means what karma is, whether am I acquiring gnanavarniya karma, darshanavarniya or moniya, what we talk about it all this time, okay? And then the ananta darshan, ananta gnan, ananta charitra, and ananta virya or energy, okay? Those are shakti. These are the all 8 categories that comes into it. Then the sthiti bandh. Sthiti means once you acquire the karma, how long is going to remain with you? Every karma, when you acquire it, there is a predetermined time. This karma will remain for so long period. There is a minimum time and there is a maximum time. Every karma associated with it. When you acquire the karma, now as time passes, you could change that sthiti of that karma. Means you can change the duration of the karma. Depending upon, you know, when you acquire the karma and you feel real guilty about it, you say, truly, I'm not going to do it again. And you truly mean that way and you are always observing all those things. Then every moment you are changing the acquired karma also. Means when you acquire the karma, you are not just duration is keep changing based on your state of mind. So never think once you acquire the karma, unless there are certain type of the karma, we call it anantanubandhi, because you have done it with the very intense kashaya. If you have done with the very intense kashaya, those duration, it's very difficult to change. Otherwise, every karma you have it, you can change. While otherwise you will never able to get liberated. If the acquired karma, if you cannot change or reduce it, and if you have to wait that long to get rid of those karma, then you will never able to attain liberation. Because during that time, you will be acquiring more karma. As time passes, you will be acquiring more and more duration of karma, means karma. That's why once you attain samyaktva, make sure all your effort is progressing towards the spirituality. If you just keep quiet and sleep, naturally you will never be able to make it also. So once you do it, you continue to work on your spirituality, whether you call it spirituality or ashram, you continuously work on it. That's why you are minimizing acquiring karma every moment. And that only you can do it that way, when you are fully aware about what you are doing. Then the third one, the anubhag bandh or ras bandh. That is the third qualities of the bondage. Anubhag or ras bandh, when karma produces the result, to what intensity it will produce. You know, some people get angry, like it is so highly fired up, okay, as if that they are going to destroy the whole world, okay. That is the ras bandh, okay. Intensity, it's a very high level when the karma produces the result. I use always anger example because it is easy to understand. But it happens to all different kashaya. Okay, krodh, man, maya and lobh. You have to think in all four. When you are cheating, see to what extent you are cheating. When you are greedy, what is the extent of your greed? When you are angry, what is the extent of the, this is the intensity. And the pradesh bandh means the quantity of karma. How much quantity of the karma is affecting. So anyway, so these are the four types of the qualities of the bondage of karma. Prakruti bandh, which you can see here. In Prakruti bandh, there are two main groups. Khati karma, which you have heard it many, many times, or Aghati karma, which are also four. The Ghati karma we call obscures and defiles the soul's natural quality. It is the quality of Atma. And it obscures the quality of the Atma. Aghati karma, it provides the physical body and related circumstances, obscures the non-physical quality or creates a physical quality. That is the Aghati karma. Technically, if you really look into it, Ghati karma is only called karma because it obscures the soul's natural quality. And when you have Ghati karma, you cannot attain liberation. Once you have all four Ghati karmas are gone, you attain Kevalgna. The four Aghati karma is not stopping you for the attainment of the Kevalgna, because Kevalgna is only defined the qualities of the soul. Now the soul's quality are not obscure at all. The soul possesses the natural quality. Natural quality, that means Ananta Darshan, Ananta Gnan, Ananta Charitra, and Ananta Virya. These are the four main qualities of the soul. And once the Ghati Karma are gone, that's what you obtain. And when the soul attains the natural quality, it will never go back to the previous state, because someone has already acquired the natural quality. He completed his destination. And now only agati karma is left, and you cannot remove the agati karma. That's only you have to keep in mind. Only agati karma you can remove it. Agati karma, you must pass through. You must go through that physical time, whatever the time that you have to pass through, like your Ayushya. If somebody comes, Bhagavan Mahavir was born with the Ayush lifespan of 72 years. So he has to complete that 72 years of the lifetime. Because in the last bow or last life, they have to complete everything, whatever they were meant for. And once it completes that, then you attain the liberation. So there is no way you can get rid of agati karma. And ultimately, there are several different processes you go through it. I don't want to go into that detail. But what I'm trying to tell you, that agati karma, it is not a hindrance. And agati karmas are all, punya karma belongs to agati karma. There are pap karma also belongs to agati karma. But in agati karma, both punya and pap are included in it. Agati pap karma means what? Agati pap karma, any agati karma body related, which is acquired due to bad conduct. What are those? Like Narka Ayushya, you acquired because of Agati Pap Karma. Somebody, let's say, is born with one leg only, that Apanga. That is also due to Papa Vagati Karma. Somebody. Say it again.
On mute.
Can you speak little loud?
No, uncle, I think somebody unmuted. So.
Oh, okay. All right. Then the Agati Karma, what I'm trying to tell you, that includes both Punya and Pap. While Ghati Karma is only Pap, because a qualities of the soul is being obscured or hindrance. When the quality of the soul, when you hinder that, it cannot be a punya karma. So you got to know the relationship between ghati, agati, and punya and pap. Ghati karmas are all due to pap karma. Agati karma, it could be due to punya karma or due to pap karma. That difference is one needs to be very clear. And third thing is, ghati karma, you can reduce it. Okay, you can reduce means that you may have acquired like more ghati karma, pap karma, but then you feel sorry, you said michami dukkadam, truly believe that way, then their magnitude is reduces, their intensity is reduces, okay, their duration is also reduces. You can make changes in the ghati karma, but you cannot make changes, in a sense, you can eliminate Agati karma. In fact, agati karmas are the last one to live. All right. So these are all these nitty-gritty differences one should know. This way you can decide the right things and how, you know, you can progress yourself spiritually. Okay. And let me get going. Just I wanted to finish the